Welcome to the Insights Hub Dashboard Designer video series, where we will give you a detailed overview of the application and equip you with all the needed information to start your journey with Insights Hub Dashboard Designer. This video will focus on how you can integrate interactive SVG graphics, integrate entire images and graphics, and animate them using the common asset structure. Generally, with the integration of SVG code into your dashboard, you can represent your own graphics in combination with interactivity. Therefore, you can use the data of a machine or a whole plant. This provides an even better overview of the data so that any problems that arise can be detected and ultimately resolved more quickly. To start integrating interactive graphics, you need to open the Dashboard Designer application. To do this, click on the Dashboard Designer icon in your Insights Hub Launchpad. Once the application has opened, select the dashboard you want to create. If you haven't created a dashboard before this video, create a new one using the New button in the top right-hand corner. If you have done everything correctly, you should be presented with the dashboard overview page. Starting point for the integration of an SVG graphic is the SVG itself. First, you have to create the graphic. If you already have one, you can skip this step of creating a SVG file. There are multiple options for creating such a graphic. One possible way is to design an image, for example with PowerPoint. In many tools, it is possible to save a file directly as an SVG graphic. If this is not working with your image processing tool, you are able to use a PNG to SVG converter to get the correct file format. For the following steps, it is now important to understand how an SVG graphic is structured. This is because it consists of many small individual shapes. In our case, for example, the production hall 2 consists of three shapes, the top and two side shapes. Each of these shapes can be assigned a unique ID in form of a string. This is a very important step, as these ID names will be used later to animate the graphic interactively. In our case, the production hall 2 top shape gets the ID, SVG underscore prod 2. The assignment of IDs to the corresponding components can either be done directly in the graphic tool in which the SVG graphic was created, or added after the design process of the graphic in one of many freely accessible online tools. After that step, your SVG code is ready for importing it to the Insights Hub Dashboard Designer. To integrate the SVG graphic, we create a new diagram with the visualization template, HTML graphics. Both HTML code and SVG code can be used in this template. We will focus on the SVG graphics in this video. The copied SVG code can be pasted into the field with the heading HTML/SVG document. By clicking in the field in which a preview of the diagrams is usually displayed, the SVG graphic is also displayed there in this case. The next step is to integrate interactivity into the graphic. To implement this feature now, you have to add a data source and a data query with an asset, an aspect, and one or multiple variables. In addition, select as a IoT query type the raw data one. In this example now, we will use the asset structure of the videos before. This means that the variables status underscore plant one is the data source for the SVG graphic. Now we want to add some additional functionalities to the SVG graphic with adding some JavaScript code. Therefore, you have two options for entering the code. The onRender code block is executed whenever new data is available. Despite that, you can even enter some code in the onInit field, where the code will only be executed when the panel will be new loaded. In this case, we use the first option, so that our code will be executed after every data refresh. At the beginning of our code block, the actual data should be written to a newly created JavaScript variable. For better understanding of the query of the data, you're able to display the whole data structure in the console of the internet browser. This could help to understand the data query command. The following step contains the IDs of the components of the SVG graphic. In JavaScript, there is a command which can write an element to your own variable. This step should be done with every component you want to animate. After finishing that, we want to implement a function that will change the style of a chosen element. Because of a query with multiple cases, a switch case query is very suitable. With the command style.fill, it is possible to change, for example, the color of an element. The selected component will be written in front of the command. By including the break keyword in every case query, it will be guaranteed that only the code of one case will be executed. In the next step, we want to implement the code for the false case. Therefore, the same code structure as for the true case will be used. However, if this case occurs, the animated object should be displayed in red. Finally, we have to call the function with the selected component and the data of the asset structure. With that function call, it would be reached that the SVG now shows the status of the plant one. This application can be very easily transferred to other cases for status displays.